There was a boy who came into this world at the hands of a holy woman in a holy place. He wore a red coat and wore temple dark, saw them reflected in the mirror of the place. Lived in the shadow of the mountains with the smiles of disinfectant, dusty old leather and the polished wood of his bear. No more than a baby feeding swans on the river, holding the hand of his mother in the wax paper bag of yesterday's bread. Ships raiding some faraway tide, with the silent dry tear of poor thoughts from abroad in his faraway eye, in his faraway eye. The smell of the wax on the wooden floor, a mixture of polish and soap. No children to fear or to play with, rows of empty hooks for the coats, an upright piano, and the boy in the choir still remind him of just before he was born. Remind him of just before he was breathing. Strange misty visions of God turn the world into a family. Little brick houses of Port Sealand sent to me the ghosts of Christmas, whispering, "You're the only one." And ever since I was a boy, I never felt that I belonged. Like everything they did to me was an experiment to see how I would cope with the illusion. In which direction would I jump? Would I do it all the same as the actors in the game? Or would I spin it back at them and not get caught up in their rules and live according to my own? And not be used to find the fundamental truths. It was gonna take some time, 55 summers down the line. The wisdom of its passing years seems to serve only to confuse. Seems to serve only to confuse. Everybody!
And he came out of the Navy, took us away to his dirty gray hometown. And he worked down a coal mine for national service so that he could be around. There was a magical purple in the glow of the exhaust of his triumph motorbike. And the warmth of oil and metal and the thrill of the heart.
Tomorrow. This inconvenience.